We'd like to start the regular press conference by Minister Motegi. Minister, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. We have already distributed to you a new augmented edition of Global 13 Overseas Safety Manual for mid-size companies and SMEs. As you will find, because of the expansion of the novel coronavirus, we have added new episodes to this manual. We have published augmented edition of animation and cartoon character Global 13 Overseas Safety Manual for SMEs. I will actually appearing in the first five pages. I will appear in eight parts of this manual under the name of Takakura, Foreign Minister. As far as the Ministry of Foreign Affairs is concerned, as a result of the terrorist attack in Dhaka that took place in 2016, we have made efforts to enhance measures to secure safety for the Japanese nationals abroad. As part of this effort, in 2017, we published Overseas Safety Manual for mid-size and SMEs, which employs the character Global 13. This manual has proven to be very popular. On top of the terrorist-related risk, there is now a need to take countermeasures against infectious diseases such as the novel coronavirus. Risk management has become very complicated. We decided to add new episodes on top of the existing manual. This new episode will be available starting from today in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs website. I would like to take this opportunity to offer our gratitude to the creator of Global 13, Mr. Takao Saito, for his efforts, for his cooperation in revising this manual. I do hope that as many people as possible will take a look at this manual and will use this as a reference for overseas safety measures. That is all. Thank you very much.
Accepting questions. Please raise your hand. After you are invited, please come forward to the microphone, tell us your name and affiliation, and then please ask your question. Yamamoto-san.
NHK, Yamamoto. Regarding China's human rights issues in Uyghur, EU and USA have decided to impose the sanctions. In your response to the parliament this afternoon, what might be effective? Respective countries might think what are effective as they decide their response. What might be the actions by Japan?
Indeed, the international society have become increasingly concerned about the Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region. There are a large number of reports alleging serious human rights violations. Recently, in addition to the U.S., EU, U.K., as well as Canada, have freshly imposed new measures. In the case of Japan, we are also gravely concerned about the human rights situation in the autonomous region. We are asking for transparent explanation to the Chinese side. As of November, when Wang Yi, the State Councilor and Foreign Minister, came to Japan, I directly spoke to him about this matter. Just the other day, at the U.S.-Japan 2+2 regarding Xinjiang Uyghur and the human rights situations, both of us shared our very grave concern. As the international community, we must work closely and must make a strong appeal to China. That is important. Regarding this aspect, of course, U.S. and Japan are collaborating. As I mentioned some countries. With these countries so far, we have had several communications. The issue is we need one voice in order to appeal to China. The position of Japan, what we will do, we will further think about our response.
Next question, please.
Tadakoto
from Mainichi Shimbun. I would like to ask about the low-altitude flights by helicopters of the U.S. forces. In 1999, you had the Japan-U.S. agreement. In that agreement, Japanese aviation law and the code will be applied to helicopters of the U.S. forces. However, it seems that the command of the U.S. forces in Japan have said that only fixed-wing vehicles will be applicable to the 1999 U.S.-Japan agreement. They've shown a different view.
I understand that there is a view. I understand that there was an exchange already, but can you please share with us your thoughts about these stance taken by the U.S. forces in Japan? As far as Japan is concerned, are you of the view, or do you intend to confirm with U.S. forces whether or not they believe that the 1999 U.S.-Japan agreement will be applicable to the helicopters? We are aware of the report with regard to the flight by the U.S. forces, inclusive of the high-level leaders. We have carried out various exchanges with U.S. forces. Right now, we have received explanations from the U.S. forces on 4 points. They have said that they have not confirmed any flights that that do not comply with the U.S. forces' rules, which are consistent with the rules of ICAO and Japanese aviation law. And because so much time has taken place since the flight, it's not easy to confirm the details. The third point was that the top priority is to secure safety upon flights, and flights of the U.S. forces are in compliance with U.S. forces rules, which are consistent with the rules of ICAO and the Japanese aviation law. And the fourth point they explained was that they have instructed all the units to once again make sure that they thoroughly comply with the U.S. forces rules when they fly. That is the explanation which we have received. We have made strong requests to the U.S. forces to pay utmost consideration to this safety, that they minimize any impact on the regional community. And of course, securing our safety is top priority. We would like to have cooperation between Japan and the U.S. on this point. Thank you.
Next question. Yes, please. Tasaki Shimotsuke, Shimbun. Regarding the manual, two questions. First of all, what do you think about how you are being depicted in the manga Golga 13? And the second is, between Golga 13 and your relationship, do you have any special feeling with Golga 13? In fact, how should I describe this? Saito Takao has kindly produced this manga comic. And of course, I respect his high level of skills of manga. Regarding Golga 13, whatever is done, there is Minister Aso seated beside myself, and he is the strongest fan.
Next question, Maino-san, please. Thank you. Maino from Nippon Television. I would like to ask about China. I understand that former diplomats of China, diplomats of Canada are detained in China. I understand that yesterday there was a trial. And I understand that unofficially 24 diplomats were present there. So Canada and the Foreign Diplomatic Corps are criticizing about the fact that the trial took place in a closed session. What are your thoughts? Yes, we understand about with regard to the matters pertaining to two candidates that are detained in China, as you pointed out. Ever since this incident has come to light, Japan has continued to monitor the situation with a sense of concern. And when we had the leaders' meeting between Japan and Canada in February, we also exchanged views on this matter. So therefore, we have been carrying out communication with Canada on this matter as far as Japan is concerned. We believe it is important that universal values such as the international community, such as respect for freedom, basic human rights, and rule of law be guaranteed in China as well.
Yes, please. Yes, please, Mr. Azahari.
Thank you. Azahari, Panorama News. My question, what kind of communications Japan had or has been taking with related countries in the Middle East over the continued attack by Houthis in Yemen on oil facilities in the region? I think last time you mentioned that Japan is taking some communications with some countries, including Iran. Any development on this? Thank you.
As was mentioned on the last occasion, as for myself, in October last year, I visited Saudi Arabia on that occasion. And in addition to that, this month, with Foreign Minister Zarif of Iran, I had the opportunity to talk on the telephone. Using such opportunities, I have been appealing to the relevant countries in order to stop the fight and realize peace in Yemen. The position of Japan is we are gravely concerned that conflict is going on for a long time and that many general public are in a dire situation in terms of humanitarian situations. Houthi are making cross-border attacks to Saudi Arabia and their attacks at the Marib. We strongly condemn that. As of yesterday, the government of Saudi Arabia has proposed a nationwide ceasefire for Yemen, which we welcome. We would like to appeal to all other parties, including Houthi, about immediate ceasefire and of an early start of dialogue for political resolution. The government of Japan will continue to support the effort of Special Envoy Griffiths of the UN in order to end the conflict of Yemen, and we will continue the support.
Any other question? If not, one more question? Please go ahead.
One question, please. What is Japan's position on the situation in Afghanistan and on the so-called war on terror in Afghanistan? It has been a long time since that war was launched, and it seems it's going forever, and it's exhausting all the countries helping Afghanistan, including Japan. And also Japan had some casualties last year, I think, Mr. Nakayama. So what is Japan's position on how to end this war? Thank you.
Well, I'm not sure whether we don't think it's been going on forever per se, but we are deeply concerned about the continued violence in different parts of Afghanistan. In particular, recently, there have been targeted killings within Kabul, and also there have been attacks on vehicles of official vehicles. We would like to strongly condemn those attacks. For the stability of Afghanistan, it is indispensable that the violence be reduced and that there be immediate ceasefire. Japan has been supporting the peace process led by Afghanistan. We will continue to work and coordinate with the international community and play a constructive role for the progress of peace. And also, to be more specific, in November of last year, at the Afghanistan conference in Geneva, I mentioned that over the next 4 years, Japan would endeavor to maintain support in the realm of roughly $180 million per annum. And in January of this year, we decided to offer $120 million worth of support for countermeasures against the COVID-19 going forward in areas such as agriculture, education, and health, where Japan has strength in terms of development. We would like to continue to offer support for the maintenance of security capacity. And through such efforts, we would like to contribute to the stability of Afghanistan. Thank you.
Further questions, please? Thank you very much. We will end this press conference by the minister. Thank you.